just another service coming through. Last five, when every single Chevy somehow caught my eye. The lady didn't know the year of even the brand, but I had that $1,000 in my hand. It was way back in the corner of this old ramshackle barn, with 30 years of dust and dirt on that green army car. And when I pulled the cover off, it took away my breath. Oh, what she called a Chevy was a 66 Corvette. And I felt a little guilty as I counted it off the bill. Oh, what a thrill I got when I sat behind the wheel. I opened up the glove box and that's when I found the note. The date was 1966 and this is what he wrote. He said, "My name is Private Andrew Malone. And if you read this, then I didn't make it home. But for every dream that's shattered, another one comes true. This car was once a dream of mine, now it belongs to you. The one taker and maker of your own. You'll always be riding with Private Malone." It didn't take me long at all. I had it running good. I'd love to hear the horses cry underneath. I had it shining like a diamond and I put the brakes out down. All the pretty girls would stop and stare as I drove through the town. The buttons on the radio didn't seem to work quite right enough, but it picked up the oldie show, especially late at night. I get the feeling sometimes if I turn real quick, I'm slowly riding shotgun in the seat right next to me. It was a young man in private, Andrew Malone, who was born for his country and never made it home. Come back, words, come back.
Dan, you too.
I went right to Valerie now, I'm not going to say that one.